I welcome you once again to the Way of Salvation program. I know your eyes are opening now to the demonic activities. And as a pastor, you are sitting up and it will cause you to do the work of God very well. So last time I was talking about the role of the pastor and demonic oppressions. You can understand that it is wrong to say that casting out demons is a special gift. And you don't have to be surprised that false prophets are trying to show some power as if they are also casting out demons. In fact, the Lord said, in that day, many will say to me that, Lord, have we not cast out demons in your name? Don't let that one surprise you, that you see false prophets supposedly casting out demons in the name of Jesus. From what I described in the other episode, it was not the name of Jesus. There is a demon that behaves like Jesus. He deceives the false prophet that he is Jesus. So when they mention, sometimes they go, in the name of Jesus! The name of Jesus! If even they say it on their mind, they don't mean my Jesus. If even he says it correctly. Demons have confessed that they don't mean your master. They don't mean my Jesus. They mean that demon. If I'm calling for a name of someone and two people have same names, and I mean the one I know, that will make it powerful. But if I don't mean you, it's deception. So that is the other side of it. It is not the name of Jesus. In other words, it is the other demon that was misleading people as if he was Jesus. That is why. The Lord said, I will disappoint them. I will tell them, I don't know you. So come to think of it. If you are casting out demons in my name, why do I say I don't know you? It means it was not him. It means you use different power. So don't be surprised when they say, if I'm not correct, why am I using the name of Jesus and they went out? Now, fine. If they are correct, I will also challenge them. Throw away the water. Throw away the oil. And certain things, and talk and listen. You see? So don't be surprised. I've opened your eyes about that one too. When they supposedly call on the name of Jesus, it is deception. They don't mean my Jesus. That is why Apostle Paul told the Galatians, in the book of Galatians chapter 1, going that if any other person comes to preach another Jesus, let him be accursed. Don't believe it. You see? It means that people can preach another Jesus, but we are talking about Jesus Christ, the Son of God. I'm talking about Jesus Christ, the Messiah. I'm talking about Jesus who was on this earth, who was born in Nazareth, who lived in Capernaum, whose apostles were Peter, were Matthew, were John, James. He's the one I'm talking about. The one who died and rose again and is seated at the right-hand side of God. Interceding for the church, coming back to judge the dead and the living. He is the one I'm preaching. So others are preaching other Jesus. And the true Jesus will disappoint them. So when you see the fake ones trying to demonstrate the power of God now, don't be surprised. Because the Lord said, many, I will disappoint many. It tells you that the false prophets are many. That is why the Lord himself said, in the last days, many false prophets will arise. So you have to understand that one. So now today I want to handle another subject. And in this episode, I'll be talking about demons and you as a sheep or a church member. All that I've done in those episodes, I was talking about demons and the pastor. Today, I'm talking about demons and you as the sheep or the church member. It is clear up to this point that who you bring your life under as a man of God to take care of your soul is very important. If you are in a room and the door that is supposed to protect you and prevent intruders is a bad door, then you are in big trouble. So I always say you should be very careful of how you bring yourself under somebody or of whom you bring yourself under to say, he's my pastor. You need to be extremely careful. But people are careless. They bring themselves under anyone. So I always ask this question, or as I put it this way, show me your pastor and I will tell you whether you are wise or foolish. Because there are some people you don't have to say is my pastor. It is a shame. If what you see today, some of these false prophets, is your pastor, you are in big trouble. If he's not from God and he's allowing demons into your life, you are in big trouble. You need to be careful of whom you place your life under as a shepherd. You need to be careful. So today I'm talking about you as a church member. Let's turn our Bibles to John chapter 10, verse 5 today. Now verse 5 says, yet they are the sheep. They are you. You are the they there. The they there refers to the sheep or the church member. It's you. They will by no means follow a stranger, but they will flee from him, for they do not know the voice of strangers. What it means is that a good church member, the good sheep, will never follow a stranger. You will run away from him because you don't know him. You don't know the stranger. According to the scripture, many shepherds are strangers. That's why I'm talking about demonic activity and how you place yourself under a shepherd. You, demons and you. You see, many shepherds are not good ones. They are strangers. And the Lord said, you should not follow a stranger. Why are they strangers? Strangers because God did not call them. God did not call them. The Almighty God did not put them in ministry. So today, I want to handle three types of strangers that you as the sheep, you as church member, you don't follow. Because if you follow them, the demons will already get you. The demons are happy when you are following their people and you are already there. So you need to be very careful of whom you follow. The first ones, I told you the other time that I will show you the types of ministers. This is the time. The first ones you shouldn't follow when they are strangers are the so-called shepherds, so-called pastors, so-called prophets who have been put there by demons themselves. That's the first group. Some of the shepherds, some of the prophets, some of the pastors are put there by demons. That is why the Lord said, I will disappoint many in Matthew chapter 7. I will disappoint many. You see? So be careful of whom you call your pastor or prophet, because many are demonic ones. Many of them. I can tell you from what I know and from what the Lord has told me, you will not believe that 99% of them are fake. 99% are false prophets. The genuine ones are unknown. Genuine ones, they are unknown. They cannot afford the television. They are unknown. Most of the ones outside are fake. So be careful. Demons put them there. Then the second one, the third one, the second one I want to talk about today are those who are self-styled. They have been in ministry by themselves. They make or they made themselves so. They are in the ministry by themselves. They appointed themselves. God did not call them. So these are the ones, the first group who have been put there by demons. They are there to mislead people, deceive them, and lock them up for demons. So what you think is church, some of them, you have entered the den of demons. You are in big trouble. They will lock you up for the demons to use you. The second group, the self-styled ones, they are the ones who are in for money. Although the demonic ones are for money, these ones also have the same agenda. They are in for money. These are the people who have no work to do, who have nothing to do, and they want to enrich themselves. They devise interesting cunning plans to deceive the ignorant. So they say they are ministers. Not all of them are from God. They are in to enrich themselves. They are in for personal advantage. Not because of you. I told you the other time that the true man of God loves the sheep. He wants to take care of the sheep. You protect them. Because that is what the Lord wants us to do. You love the church people, that you don't want any demon to devour them. But this one, the self-styled ones, they don't care. They came for themselves, not for you. The third group is in verse 12 and 13. The Lord said, but the hireling, who is not the shepherd, one who does not own the sheep, sees the wolf coming, and he leaves the sheep and flees. And the wolf catches the sheep and scatters them. Verse 13 says, the hireling flees because he is a hireling and does not care about the sheep. So the third group of people, you as a sheep, you as a church member who want to be free from demons, is that you have to flee from them, is the hireling. What does the Lord mean? These are the men who are hired by other men. They are hired by other men to lead you. And that is also very funny. Very, very funny. I ask this question. Please, can I go to KLM and I appoint a managing director for them? And I will tell the workers, this is your managing director. Or can I be at AT&T and I bring a man to the workers and I say, AT&T, today this is your manager. You can imagine. This is ridiculous. Nobody can choose a boss, a manager, a servant for somebody. Church people are choosing servants for God. It's very sad. The worst of all are those who vote in church. We vote not according to the voice of God, but according to the tongue of human beings. And they will choose a servant to serve God. Hey, this is interesting. Very interesting. Human being choosing somebody who should serve God. That is very interesting. You, as a church member, should run away from these places. Because he is hired by men. I saw an advertisement one day. And it reads like this. Church people are looking for a pastor. On the top, the heading was vacancy, vacancy, vacancy. The church is looking for a pastor. Salary is good. All the benefits are negotiable. Interested applicants should apply. Did I hear him say apply? This work is calling. So this third group, if you are running away from demons, don't go near them. Because human beings hire them. And that is dangerous. They take the work of God as a secular job. These are the people who say, I have retired from preaching. It shouldn't be so at all. So be very, very careful that you will not go and follow any person who is hired by men to be leaders of the church. The Lord said, the good sheep, the person who wants to be protected from demons, that person will never follow this person. Don't follow any person who is hired by church people, who knows nothing. There's something interesting about the churches that are spreading across the world by senior pastors. Because they strive to have churches all over the world, something funny is going on. They will come to America, look for somebody who even they have not trained. Some of them even attended their services back home in Africa for a short time. Because of money and because of fame, they will put such people there. They don't know anything. Within a short time, the church people's eyes begin to open and they revolt against such man. Why? They begin to see that this person knows nothing. Why? He was hired by the senior pastor so that he can do the work there for him. The Lord said, you as the good sheep, you don't follow such a person. He says, you will run away from such a person because he's a stranger. Now the Lord says something interesting. He said, that man who is hired, when he sees wolf coming, he says he will leave the sheep. The wolf is the demon. The wolf is the demon. So you say you are called. You say you belong to a church. Wait. The dead demons will begin to attack the church. You will see. That man will run away and leave you. These are the people who say, when you are dying and you call him, he will say, I'm going on holiday. I was shocked one day when the pastor said, my church member died. And they informed me of it. And by that time, I planned my holiday. So I didn't listen to them. I even didn't go there to offer my condolences. I went ahead and went on a holiday to entertain my wife. Hey, you bring this on TV. This on TV. And people are listening. This man has no heart for church people. You see? So if you are afraid of demons, when the wolf is coming, look for someone who can stay. This man will run away and leave. He says, the wolf will catch the sheep and scatter them. That is what you see in churches where they hire people. It is a secular job. He's only doing it for the money. He will never pray for you. You have to be careful. So today I say, I'm talking to you. If you are afraid of demons, run away from this type of men of God. Verse 13 says, he says, he flees because he was hired. He didn't. He was not called by God to take care of you. They hired me to talk. That is a preaching. They hired me just to talk so that they pay me. It's a profession. So he has no compassion. I was saying the other time that he doesn't even have the comb. The comb he doesn't have. Let alone the passion. Only the comb, even the comb he doesn't have. Let alone the passion. So you don't follow such a person. Verse 13 says, he does not care about the sheep. He does not care. I want to ask a question. If you are afraid of demons, would you like to put your life under someone who doesn't care of you? Who does not care about you? Will you do that? Definitely not. You shouldn't do that. You see? So that is what I want you to understand. If a pastor is a stranger, you have to run away because he does not have compassion for you. Follow the one who is actually called. And it's a strong door spiritually. Check. Next time I will continue from here. But check if the one you have placed your life under as a pastor is a strong door spiritually. A door that wolves cannot break and come in. Then you can sleep. Rest, be rest assured that I have a pastor. Today it's not so. It is not so at all. They are enriching themselves, showing off their wealth. But go inside the church and see what is happening. You'll be shocked that what they bring outside is completely different from what is inside. May God open your eyes and stay in a church where demons cannot get to you because the man is either put there by demons. I'm talking about the shepherd. If he's put there by demons, then he's there to work for them. Number two, if he came by himself, next time I will show you how to detect these things. Then number three, if they hired him, run away. These are the pastors who can be a pastor for any church, regardless of their doctrine. If you can only pay and give me money, I'll be your pastor. Let your eyes open and sit up because demons are still at work. May God open your eyes. I will constantly tell you, I don't want you to be in hell. I want us to be in heaven. That is why the Lord sent me to open your eyes with these messages. God bless you. I will see you again. Bye-bye.
Thank you for watching this video. I really hope you have been enlightened. To hear more, you may subscribe to this channel and click the notification bell to see more videos. Pastor Kukudatsi has written a very informative book called How Demons Operate. Grab yourself a copy to know how they operate and know how to liberate yourself from demonic oppression. To stay in contact with us, you can reach us through these details. God bless you.